Welcome back, dear viewers. You're still watching Nile Cruz here on Nile TV International. President Assisi has directed the restoration of the shrines of the El Bayt family, especially the tombs of Sayyid Anfisa, Sayyid Zainab, and Imam Al Hussein Mosque. Assisi met with the head of the Armed Forces Engineering Authority and discussed the restoration of the interior halls of mosques and their sophisticated architectural decorations. The restorations will be in keeping with the historical pedigree of the sites. The development of the surrounding roads, squares, and other facilities will also match the heritage of the shrine. With us now here is heritage researcher Rana Iheb to talk to us about this subject. Thank you very much, Rana. Always a pleasure to have you with us.
Thank you.
Rana, what are, in your view, the most important shrines surrounding the Salah al-Din Castle, the place we are in now?
Actually, we have a lot of amazing shrines, amazing mausoleums, but the most important for us, which is related for the people and related to their history, their hearts going on, and they ask it anything for they want from those places or those mausoleums. So we can said because the Salah al-Din Citadel is near to the necropolis of Mamluks, so we can search about the most important mausoleums there. So for example, Imam al-Shafi'i and all of those things. But the most important, and during our talk we talk about mausoleum of Imam al-Shafi'i. This is one of the most mausoleums that restored before days ago. So it's amazing. The decoration itself, the inscription inside it. So it make a people or to allow to the people to visit it. So this is something help us in the developing of our city, developing of our tourism and those stuff.
Wonderful, Rana. So what is the historic importance of shrines in general, shrines of the Prophet, peace be upon him, family members?
The importance here, it's not about only because for sure this is related to the Prophet Muhammad himself, and also because it's in Egypt. So if we looked where is the place of the Prophet Muhammad and his message, where is the immigration that happened in his time, it happened all of them in Saudi Arabia now, or Arabian Venezuela in the past. So talking about those important people from the house of the Prophet Muhammad here in Egypt, here is the most important thing. We said the Egyptian people, they are a religious people, especially Islam. So they beloved, this is something near to their hearts. If I found one from the house of Muhammad, peace be upon him, here in Egypt, so I will appreciate everything related to them.
Indeed, Rana. It is to mention that the Al-Ashraf Syndicate, the descendants of the Prophet, peace be upon him, have thanked the President for his directives to develop the shrines of the Al-Bayt mosques. Now, Rana,
yes.
Restoration of monuments in general has two sides of one coin, maybe. From one side, we want to restore the things and keep them, you know, in good shape. But from the other side, a restoration could take away from the originality of the monuments. What's your intake on that?
My opinion or my point of view as a researcher from this point, actually we have to focus what is the meaning of restoration. The process of the conservation itself has many definitions under the great umbrella of conservation. So if we do it by the correct way and we choose the right term for the right place, for sure it will be something completely different. Some people said, if I going to preserve a place or restore a place, I will destroy the originality.
Yeah.
I want to destroy the history. Mm. I will destroy the intangible heritage of that.
Yeah.
But this is actually not true. Mm. So if I keep the place in the right way of restoration or in the right way of the preservation, it can allow to the people who come after a long time to see how this place is amazing. The story is not only about a stone. Even I have a one stone about something. This stone can narrate for us a long stories about how important this place.
That's true. Now, Rana, what are and you're a heritage researcher. What are the forms of heritage present inside the big castle we are in today, the Salah al-Din Castle?
Actually, Salah al-Din Castle is one of the most important of the historical Cairo. All the historical Cairo is listed one of the places in the World Heritage List in the UNESCO. So it's we cannot say only the castle or the Mamluk's necropolis or Mu'izz Street. All of them is connected to each other. So all of them is amazing. During your walk on the street, you will feel how it's the power of history, how was the amazing of the people who lived in this or in the past. Each stone, as I mentioned, telling us a story about something happened. Even the handicrafts in this place, it's amazing because if we focusing on the speaking of the prime minister about the historical Cairo, he mentioned that the handicraft is one of the most important things, not only in Egypt, it's only in Cairo, because it started from Cairo and should be not end until the end of the world. So this is important. Everything surrounding this area is listed, is important to mention, is important to tell our children, our parents. If I'm a researcher, a lot of people around us should know about how important of this place.
Indeed. And I know that you have groups of students that you tell
yes,
those
exactly.
stories too. So Rana, how can we make a better form of marketing a place like this, in your view? And we are in a new era. I mean, era of social media, perhaps. So marketing such a historical place, how do we work
yes,
on that?
Actually, most of the people who are foreigner people, what they know about Egypt is only a desert and only we have the pyramids.
Yeah.
No, this is completely wrong. We have of amazing and fantastic places like the place we are in now, the Mosque of Muhammad Ali, one of the masterpieces in all the world. So the marketing should work on the colorful things, on the buildings, and the art itself and the decoration of the heritage, everything related to this. Because when we mentioned Egypt, just the people think about the pyramids. This is not true. We have from each important civilization in this world, we have a fingerprint here in Egypt. And this is important to focusing on the things as decorated, the colors, not only the desert and the pyramids and those things who's coming from the excavation, because this is what come in the minds of the people when we talk only about Egypt. So we need to correct this idea by taking a lot of photos, videos, and actually Ministry of Antiquities started to do this kind of marketing now, which is amazing.
Very important indeed, Rana, and it is to mention that it is from here that Cairo and Egypt used to be ruled, from the Salah al-Din citadel or castle for a long period of time, and that this mosque, and we will conclude by this, Rana, this mosque was built in, it started to be built in 1830, and building continued till 1848, and then we have renovations in the King Farouk
In the King Farouk, and exactly, we have now a restoration in the open court of the Muhammad Ali Mosque, on the fountain, on the colors. Actually, one
so
of
take
the
us to a tour. Take us to a tour now.
And sure.
We're next to the mosque.
Yes, exactly. One of the most important things happened in the Citadel of Salah al-Din, also the clock tower, which is opened, which is a gift from Louis the Ninth from France. So it's amazing to work to hear this clock for the first time. It's kind of amazing. The restoration and the decoration also of the ceiling of the mosque, the golden things, and we can now see this from Salah al-Din Street, Salah Salim Street. We can see the domes. It's shining now because it's gilded with kind of materials who give this shiny like what was in the ancient times. So this is a This is what happens in the Muhammad Ali, especially because we are standing now in Muhammad Ali Mosque.
Yes, indeed, it is beautiful to watch it from outside and from inside.
Exactly.
Rana Ihab, heritage researcher. Always a pleasure to have you with us.
Thank you, Rana. Thank you.
Dear viewers, please stay with us. There is more to come here on Nile Cruise. Don't go away.